Students, good morning. Today we will discuss about chapter 2, standard 8, computer, that is access to MS Access. Okay, access to MS Access. And actually chapter 1's question answer not given, and it will be given as soon as possible. I'm trying my level best. First of all, we will know that Microsoft Access, okay, Microsoft Access, about Microsoft Access, or we can say that is MS Access. My MS stands for Microsoft Access. What is that? It is a relational database management system, RDBMS. Don't need to be worried. It is a relational database management system, and it can where somebody can create file or table, modify, okay, create, modify, and maintain the database. Maintains the database, that is DBMS, database management system. Question arises here, how to maintain, how to create, how to modify, right? For creating the MS Access, okay, we have to draw the relation or draw out the relations between what? Between the various database stored in the computer, right? Stored in the computer, and that is any information that can be retrieved. Remember, retrieved means access. Retrieved using a particular software, right? We are using lots of, like I told you, lots of application software we are using by installing them all to the computer or to our systems, right? And it is because of reason, and it is the because of reason that we can retrieve the data from the internet to the online, and etc. It is because of one reason is feasibility. Okay? The reason was for which we can access relational database management is because of its feasibility. So, most of the popularly database management system found to all over the world, that is RDBMS. Little more I want to discuss, right? Suppose in a medicine store, you do not know the name. You went to that medicine store and you ask the medicine person to purchase a medicine. But we don't know the name. We have the cover of medicines, right? That magic ointment or whatever. Then what? It will check whether the composition of medicine, okay, whether the compositions of medicine is become equal or not, and where it is stored. So that is a system how to find out or how to retrieve data from a database management system. Okay, next we will move how to getting started with MS Access. How to start MS Access from standard 7 also, you know. How to start? Go to start button. Okay, there is the desktop. Then click on all programs. Then there will be Microsoft Office. Click on Microsoft Office. Okay. Then Microsoft Office Access will be there. Whether it is of version 2010 or 12 or 2020, whatever its version, Microsoft Office will be there. There it will show Microsoft Word Excel, Microsoft Word, Microsoft Word Excel, then Microsoft PowerPoint and etc. Right? So after getting started, we will know what are the basic components of the MS Access. Basic component of MS Access, first one is, that is title bar. Title bar, right? When we open a new document from MS Access, then title bar will be there on the topmost. It displays the name of the currently opened database. Okay, suppose whether it is a blank or any saved document, whatever, but it will help you to show the currently opened document. Okay, then file tab. File tab will be there. File tab will be there. File tab shows the backstage view of file command, such as whether you want to open a new file or you want to access the file already saved in your MS Access. Okay, then quick access toolbar will be there. Quick access toolbar. Quick access toolbar will be there. It displays the access button. Whether you want to save it directly or undo or using the commands. Okay, that is called quick access toolbar. If you remember the name of the file, then you can type with the format in which it is saved. Then it can also be accessed using the quick access toolbar. Then ribbons. Okay, ribbons will be there in the left corner. Another, there will be ribbons. Ribbons. It is helpful for displaying the group of related commands in the tags, and each tab offers a shortcut button to the command tags. Okay. Then database object. What are database object? Database objects are, there are four main type of database object. Four main types of database object. What are these? One is tables, then queries, then forms, reports, etc. Not etc. These are the four main types of data object. Okay. These objects are useful when we access MS Access. Then another will be there. Navigation pane, it lists out all the available objects rather than this four. Okay, or other than this four. Navigation pane. Then one is status bar. Status bar displays the information about the current object's view or the object earlier it is done or set. Okay, next one is work area. Another one is work area. Work area what? It differs according to the database of the element selected. It differs according to the database or the element according they are selected. Whether pictures is getting larger or smaller, or you want to enlarge it or magnify it more, etc., etc. So these are the basic component of MS Access. Okay, and next we will discuss what is the actual definition of database, what are the advantages, disadvantages, what are useful, not useful, okay, component of database, and then how to create blank database, reports, tables, queries, forms, reports, etc. Okay, and in the next class I will discuss. For today, this is the just introduction about your second chapter. And yes, again I am repeating, question answer of the first chapter will be provided soon. Okay, I am trying within 2 days I will give you question answers. You check it and mark it yourself. Thank you. Have a good day.